Hello everyone, my name is Alice Fisher and I teach computer science. I'm going to share a few ideas about giving students space to stumble. In other words, allowing them to learn from their mistakes in a low stakes environment. Before I begin talking about my students, I'd like to share a little bit about myself. This is me at age 6. I know, pretty adorable. And these are my parents, who have always been very loving people. But when I was 6, I got caught crumpling worksheets that I didn't get 100% on and hiding them in my closet. When I look back, I think, wow, why did I feel such pressure to not be perfect, even at age 6? I'm not sure where that pressure came from, parents, school, myself. Whatever was the source, we teachers have students like myself at age 6 who are afraid to fail because the stakes can seem so high. Sometimes the student's perception reflects elements of the academic landscape they live in. In Texas, if you graduate in the top 10th or even the 6th percentile in some schools, you receive automatic admission to Texas public universities. And whether you're from Texas, we know that college admissions have been more and more competitive. So with this in mind, this brings me to the question, how do I carve space in my classroom so that students feel safe to make mistakes, take risks, ask questions, and trust us as teachers to have their best interest and growth in mind? For as Jessica Leahy discusses in her book, The Gift of Failure, small failures when the stakes are relatively low and the potential for emotional and cognitive growth is high are called desirable difficulties. Learning that comes with challenge is stored more effectively and more durably in the brain than learning that comes easily. We want our students to stumble because that is how they best learn. Now, at this point, we could start discussing alternative methods of grading, such as competency-based grading or standards-based grading, but I only have 4 minutes. So, even if you grade traditionally, how do we carve these safe spaces for students to stumble? I will now discuss a few strategies I use in my AP Computer Science A course, which is learning to program in Java. And unfortunately, we can see that traditionally, it's been underrepresented from female and minority students. So strategy number one, reinforce the message that learning is iterative. Give students the opportunity to learn through a second iteration of an exam. While I was grading a free response question exam late last fall, I thought to myself, why should I be making detailed notes of all the errors that the students are making when the students can be making these notes and learning from their mistakes? And so this is what I did. If the students wrote code correctly, minus a few minor syntax errors, I gave them a check plus, and if not, I left it blank. When the students received their exam back, they also received a handout for the second iteration of their exam. On the handout, they were assigned to debug their code and write the revised code in the box provided if they didn't receive a check plus. Now, they were all required to type their code and test with test cases. They documented their errors, explained how they debugged their code, whether it was due to incorrect syntax or incorrect logic. And I actually only took a grade on the second iteration of their exam. Strategy number two, spiraling past content into more recent assessments and replacing past assessment scores with more recent assessment scores if they show evidence of growth in the spirit of standards-based testing. For example, I gave a quiz and the majority of my students didn't do that great. So the next test I gave had two parts. Part one consisted of 10 multiple choice questions that spiraled the content from the previous quiz, and part two is new content. Now, I graded part one, and if the percent of that section was higher, I replaced the past quiz's score with a new score. And of course, the students did better the second iteration and learned the content at a deeper level. Strategy number three, encourage peer tutoring and collaboration. When I gave that second iteration of that exam, I gave some students stickers so that they would give those to peers that helped them understand the problem better, And those peers received little prizes like Hershey Kisses and erasers, which sent the message that I really value helping each other out. We also do group activities, such as posters where the students can talk about certain topics, and this helps create a community of learning in the classroom. Strategy number four, and this is the tough one. Acknowledge mistakes that I've made and how I've learned from student questions. This is the first year I've taught AP Computer Science A, and I've definitely done my share of stumbling. Although it can be humbling, I've learned to incorporate my mistakes as a learning lesson for students. When I taught the topic of private access, I didn't quite understand that private fields have class level and not object level access. One of my students asked a question that revealed the limits of my understanding, so I incorporated her question into the next day's lesson and acknowledged her in my research into the topic, which resulted in better understanding. I'll end with a quote. Learning is deeper and more durable when it is effortful. Learning that's easy is like writing in the sand, here today, gone tomorrow. Buddhist monks create and then destroy intricate sand art to symbolize the impermanence of life. We educators know about impermanence in education. We want to be the stability in our student lives and provide them space to grow, take risks, and learn at a deeper level so that their understanding can take root and endure beyond our classroom doors. Thank you.